The world seems to be full of people now on low sugar diets, low carb diets, ketogenic diets, carnivore diets, and they all swear that sugar is the evil incarnate of nutrition. And this video is not about that. I'm not going to be talking about sugar and how sugar is linked to various diseases and obesity epidemics and things. I'm going to talk about sugar as a food group and whether or not we actually need it at all. So welcome to Shape Fixer. I'm Andrew, I'm a nutritionist, I'm a sports coach, I'm a retired elite athlete, and I used to be overweight and sick, and now I am much healthier. Now, when you think about nutrition and you start from scratch based on the science that we have, and you are going to decide what you need to eat, it's got to be based on what your body needs. So we can start off with building blocks. We need to build and repair our tissues, and for that we need to be eating protein, because that's how we get the amino acids to build our own proteins like collagen and muscle tissue. And so we need food with protein in it. So that means generally animal products. There are ways of getting protein from eating plant products, so you can get away with it as a vegan, but you've got to be careful. But you've got to eat protein. Fine. Meat, fish, eggs, maybe cheese, beans, if you're a vegan, tofu. There are ways of getting your protein. The next thing your body needs as another kind of building block is fats. 30% of your brain is made of fat. Fat is absolutely essential to your nervous system. Fat is absolutely essential in the construction of your cell membranes. So fat has a very important nutritional role to play as well. So we've got to get our fats. That means olive oil or animal fat or butter. Wherever we're getting our fats and oils from, could be nuts, could be avocados, but we need to include oils and fats in our diet. So there we go. We've got proteins, we've got fats. Now we are building our body, and we need certain vitamins and minerals to keep everything going, and you can get some of those minerals in the foods that we've already discussed. You might want to add some vegetables. You might want some fiber. There are debates about fiber going on at the moment, and the science is kind of going in both directions, so I'm not going to get into whether or not you really need a lot of fiber, but if you think you do, then you need to be eating green vegetables, and you need to keep your salts in balance. So electrolytes, but that's pretty much it, and we're done, except that you need energy. You need energy to run all the systems. Otherwise, you're not going to build anything. You're not going to create your hormones that then modulate your metabolism. So where do you get the energy from? Well, if you look back at what we've already decided we're going to eat, you get it from the fat. Fats and oils burn. And so you can get your energy from there. But now I hear a voice from the past over there saying, what about sugar? And I say, what about sugar? Well, you got to have sugar. You didn't put sugar in your nutrition. So why would I do that for? For energy. But I've got fat. I'm burning fat for energy. Yes, but you need sugar. No, I don't need sugar. What do I need sugar for? Well, you need carbohydrates then. But hang on, but that is sugar. So what is a carbohydrate going to contribute to my body that I'm not going to get from eating proteins and fats and green vegetables? What am I going to get? You're going to get energy. No, we discussed that. I've got my energy from burning fat. I don't need sugar for my energy. Now I can. It does burn, but it doesn't do anything else. It doesn't contribute anything nutritionally. It's not actually food. It's not nutrition. It shouldn't be a food group. Carbohydrates shouldn't be a food group. They are a fuel source. They are not the only fuel source, because the other fuel source is fats and oils, which you have to have because you need them for your brain and for your nervous tissue. You don't need the sugars for anything else because they don't build anything. So actually having sugar just for the sake of burning it just gets in the way, because it interferes with your metabolic system and it interferes with your hormone production so that other systems don't work as well as they should. So carbohydrates are not a food group, and sugars are not an essential part of a diet. Then they are not food. Sugars are not food. Thank you for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Thank you for sharing this video. Please comment down below if you have anything you want to say about this. If you are a believer like I was for a very long time that carbohydrates are so important as a part of our diet, because that's what the American government told us in the 1970s, it's a bit out of date. Please comment below and let's have the conversation. Let's keep it respectful and not be ridiculous. Let's focus on the science and let's talk about this, because I think it's really interesting. And it's been quite eye-opening for me to look at it this way rather than just, are they going to do me harm or not? The point is, we don't need them at all.